Gabby. I am so excited to share with you the second video that we're gonna be doing all about eyebrows. So I have decided to bring in the master of eyebrows, Ms. Gabby right here. And I just wanna mention to all of you that you never know who you're gonna run into in any part of your life. I met Gabby because she was my dental hygienist. Who knew? Yes, she was all up in my teeth, all up in my gums, and lo and behold, she is now my inspiration because she took a leap of faith in her own world and decided to follow her true passion and joy. So she used to say that I inspire her, but no, no. This girl is inspiring me because she has taken that leap of faith on life. Let's just get into the nuts and bolts of this whole video, which is all about microblading and also ombre. And I've learned a couple things about like nano and tapping. So Gabby does it all. And honestly, I didn't know what the differences were. And she was saying that microblading is out, like going out. Who knew? The differences are between this nano and microblading.
Okay, so microblading is done with a manual machine or a manual tool. And what it basically does is the artist puts pigment on the tool and slices through the skin. And during that process, the pigment is deposited into the skin. Versus nano hair strokes is done with a tattoo machine using a single needle. And it's at a fast pace, I guess. The needle is going pretty fast. And the artist just goes in a very slow motion so those little dots can connect and make a line. So it's more on the surface, less trauma, better retention. Biggest difference between the two is that when you do nano machine hair strokes, anybody's a candidate. Versus microblading, you have to have dry to normal skin. So that eliminates a lot of people because let's face it, a majority of us have oily T-zones. Mm-hmm. And so that's why a lot of girls go get microblading and they say it didn't last, that it lasts about 6 months, or that it just blots out and looks kind of like a powder brow.
Gabby was showing mine in her hand. She has an example of a microblading and a nano, but the nano is much crisper of a line and looks truly like a hair stroke versus the microblading, which is something I've never heard of before. So getting into the retention, there are so many things make or break your results. So when you come in where you fill out all your information and like the medications, like do you have XYZ? Because there's a lot of factors that can play a role in the retention of your eyebrows. So Gabby mentioned a couple of them, including smoking or vaping. So kind of go into that.
Yeah, your skin is the largest organ of your body, and whatever's going on the inside of your body manifests in your skin. So heavy smoking, whether it be cigarettes or vaping, that plays a huge role. If you're sick and you don't know about it, that plays a huge role in retention. Aftercare, all of that. There's so many things that go into the aftercare that most people probably don't think about, but that's very, very important, you know. And if you're investing in brows, follow the aftercare. I mean, the most important days are 7 to 10 days. After that, then you got a little bit more wiggle room for sure.
And you're kind of mentioning like if you do get a lot of face treatments like microneedling or maybe microdermabrasion, that could play a role.
Yes, yes. Anytime that I have a client reach out to me and they say that they do microneedling or chemical peels, I always get in contact with their tech and we collaborate together to kind of just determine what's the best for the client.
So Gabby, what is the most asked question you get from people who reach out to you?
The number one question that I get is, does it hurt? And they follow up with, they're scared. We do use numbing agents for any of the procedures. I feel like a lot of clients say that they feel like a little stinging maybe in the beginning until I put the numbing product on. But after that, I mean, I've literally had girls snoring in my chair from just falling asleep.
Wow.
And just feeling so relaxed. I've never had anybody in excruciating pain or anything. So it really just depends on the artist, you know. Some of us are light-handed, some of us are heavy-handed. With the numbing, less is more for us because the more we use that, the more it does push out the pigment and that affects the retention. So that's something that we have to keep in mind. But it's not painful at all, you know, the eyebrows are not. Other permanent makeup services can be a little bit more painful just depending on the, you know, the area of the body, like eyeliner. And lips could be a little bit more painful because those are more sensitive, but the brows, I mean, the girls knock out in my chair. And another thing I wanted to clarify is that the microblading, ombre tattoos, machine hair stroke, it's all considered micropigmentation. So the difference with that and tattoos is that we don't go as deep into the skin. Mm. So that makes a huge difference in pain threshold. So we go a little past the first layer, and that's why it's considered semi-permanent, why it lasts 1 to 3 years. And it helps the color. You know, if we go too deep, that's how you get the ashy blue brows, you know, like all those old school 1990s tattoos. You see these older ladies walk around with like orange eyebrows or blue eyebrows. That's because that pigment was put in way too deep, and that's how it's healed.
Oh,
really
goodness.
Ashy. Yeah.
I'm so happy that we've excelled from those days.
I know, right?
Now for the next extremely important thing with getting your eyebrows done is choosing your technician. So what do we need to know?
Yes. So your technician should be certified. Right now, the state of Illinois doesn't really have many regulations. You know, we're considered tattoo artists. So literally, your tattoo artist can go and get a 2-day class, or they can get a 5-day class. I took a 5-day course. It covered 3 different techniques, and I thought I was going to be done with that and know everything, and oh my god, I have taken so many more courses since then. I was just telling Carly, like, I have so many more certificates that I have to hang up because it's just, it's ongoing learning process.
When you're a baller shot caller, you just keep the education.
Yes, you do. And I mean, you're working on people's faces, you know, you always want to know the latest techniques. You know, retention is important. I mean, you can create the bombest brows at that first appointment, but if they don't retain, then it doesn't mean anything,
right?
You know? So yes, you want a certified technician. You want them to be insured for sure. The location. Do not go anywhere where the girl's like, yeah, it's in my house, or, you know, I just have it in my garage. You can just come through, you know?
Don't get your eyebrows in an alley, ladies.
No. A health inspector has to come check your place out. Be in a clean environment so there's no cross-contamination, there's no risk for infection. Definitely check out your artist. You know, look at her work. See if that's even something that you want. You know, there's a wide range of artists that charge from like $200 to charge to $1,000. Usually the girls that charge higher, they're vets. They've been doing it for 5-9 years, you know, they know what they're doing. They've paid for, you're paying for their education, basically. You know, you're gonna get great results. So just word of mouth too. If you got friends that, you know, had their eyebrows done and you love the way they look, check out their work, and you know, that's always a good source.
Okay, so now we're gonna do a couple of things. So first, we're actually going to do my eyebrows, but first we need to know, like, what is the process of this whole thing?
Yes, so first and foremost, medical history needs to be filled out to make sure you're even a candidate. And then we go into the consultation process, which is mapping out your eyebrows. We're looking for symmetry and just shaping your eyebrows, using your natural anatomy as landmarks and measurements. It's important to get perfect shaped brows. And I pick a custom color. You know, we figure out what's going to match your natural hair color and also your lifestyle. And then we get into it. Sometimes you'll get numbed first, sometimes you won't, just depending on skin type. And oiliness, all that fun stuff, tones, all that plays a big role. And then I do my first pass, open up the skin, and then I numb you. I do about 2 or 3 passes depending on how dense you want the brows. And then after that, we review aftercare.
Now let's have some fun and show you how it is done. This was so much fun. I'm so excited that Gabby was here to do my first collaboration video on this. So first and foremost, how do we find you?
Yes, I'm in St. Charles. Tri-City, baby.
Everything will be down below for her link, her Instagram, the full gamut. So reach out to her. So let's all empower each other every single day to be the best that we can be. And why not be the best that we can be in amazing eyebrows? Yes. So thank you all for watching, and we will see you soon. Bye. Bye.